everyone. Welcome and thank you for joining me for another multisensory art experience. My name is Maureen De Silva and my pronouns are she and her, and I'm an art educator here at the AGO. In this video, I thought we could have some fun activating an abstract work by Toronto-based artist K.M. Graham. An especially fun fact about K.M. Graham is that she used to be a docent here at the AGO. Here we are. Back when the institution was known as the Art Gallery of Toronto, I find her career trajectory particularly inspiring, and I look forward to sharing this particular work with you. But first, I would like to take a moment to offer an acknowledgement to the land in which the AGO is situated and where K.M. Graham worked. So on the screen right now is a shot of the AGO on Dundas West at the corner of McCall Street. And this is the view that you would have if you were walking east on Dundas West, and you would be able to see the beautiful wood and glass facade that emerges from our Gallery Italia designed by Frank Geary. So let's do a land acknowledgement. The Art Gallery of Ontario operates on land that is the territory of the Anishinaabe Mississauga Nation and was also the territory of the Wendat and Haudenosaunee. The Dish with One Spoon Wampum Belt Covenant is an agreement between the Haudenosaunee Confederacy and the Anishinaabe Three Fires Confederacy to peaceably share and care for the resources around the Great Lakes. Toronto is also governed by a treaty between the federal government of Canada and the Mississaugas of the Credit Anishinaabe Nation. Toronto has always been a trading center for First Nations. Okay. Before we begin, I want to let you know what to expect for this session. You will hear some creative and interpretive audio description, exploratory questions, and we'll try to activate this painting with a bit of tactile work. I wrote textile here, and we're going to sort of end up making a textile, but really the idea is that we're going to be doing something that activates our sense of touch as we experience this work. I'm also going to give you some context for the artist herself, who only began making art as a career at the age of 50 upon the death of her husband. So, what are we going to need for our tactile slash textile activation? Here's a list of tools. So you'll definitely need some bobby pins. If you have different sizes and colors, great. Don't sweat it if you don't. If you have Q-tips instead or any sort of dowel, you just don't want anything with a super sharp edge, since we're going to be playing with these with our hands. So anything in that range that kind of has this stick straight sort of structure and that you can easily move. Then we will also need to have some paper to balance that. So it doesn't really matter what kind of paper, whatever you have lying around the house. Since I'm also an artist, I happen to have some fun art papers, but honestly, you can use computer paper, you can use parchment paper from your kitchen, whatever you have lying around, really great. If you'd like to have some tape to sort of secure your work at the end, that's an option. I haven't listed it in here, but it's not really super important for the active part of this, but you can have that there too, if you like. So we're going to start with a description of the art. So I'm going to disappear from your corner and introduce you to the work. We are exploring a painting by K.M. Graham called Alleluia. It's an abstract piece painted with acrylic paint on canvas, sitting in portrait orientation. The size of the piece is roughly 6'5" in height and is just over 5 feet long. So it's like a really tall human standing up and a really shorter one, about my height actually, lying down. So this is quite substantial in size, and it's in line with the idea that many other abstract artists had about painting on oversized canvases as they will invite the viewer to have a full visual experience by taking up so much space. So I'm going to begin now to describe the content of this work, but keep in mind that an abstract piece is always open to interpretation for its form. So all the art making in this painting sits against a white backdrop. In the center of the canvas, all the marks appear to radiate out from what appears to be a heart shape in silhouette. The heart reveals the most of the white background on the canvas, and its shape is outlined by streaks of paint that seem to burst from the implied contour. The streaks of color have a liquid and organic form, looking like water that might spill across a surface. In fact, the paint appears to be watered down and loose, and in certain locations, there are splatter marks from her brush. The movement of the artist's hands appear to be in these oblong shaped strokes, and the marks are made with a variety of colors. All three primary colors appear prominently in this piece, with a blue sitting on top of a red, sitting on yellow, and in some places, because the colors are quite translucent, they actually mix to create secondary ones like green, orange, and dark purple directly on the canvas. We can also parse out that a very light purple, perhaps even a kind of washed out lilac, pops up behind all the primary colors on its own. So I don't think that this purple is a result of mixing directly on this canvas, but rather applied independently as its own pigment by the artist. The marks or splashes, if you will, radiate all the way from the central heart shape to the very ends of the canvas and are contained by the canvas's edges. This piece is an exploration of color and texture, and its name given by the artist may work together to provoke a variety of sensations and understandings. So let's take a moment with this description and consider what associations you come up with between the artwork and the title, because the title is quite evocative. It's meaning to express something, and the artist most certainly would have been aware that people would come to experience her work with a certain attachment or association with the word Alleluia. And I'm gonna say Alleluia, but also remind you that I described this as sort of radiating from a central heart. So think about that description with the title and what associations you personally come up with. What comes up for you? What feelings do you think Graham was really trying to capture? What do you think of this artwork in particular? Let's talk a little bit about the artist herself. For those of you that are curious, the KM stands for Kathleen Margaret. She was born in 1913 and passed away in 2008. So we're definitely still within the realm of contemporary artists. And in the beginning of the video, I mentioned two things about her. One is that she only began her career in earnest at the age of 50. And the other is that she was a docent at the AGO for a period in her life. I like highlighting the age in which she started her career because I think it's important to celebrate that art careers can really begin at any age. And I find it inspiring to myself as an artist to hear of people taking such leaps in later parts of their lives. I don't feel so rushed myself. And really, K.M. Graham, despite starting so late, produced a prolific number of works. It really just adds another layer of accessibility to art making for me to really not limit the starter timeline of our careers only to our youth. The second part is wonderful too, as part of her experience working at the AGO was the regular exposure to abstract artists, both international and Canadian, that helped shape her interests and explorations. In Alleluia, we can take from this a fascination with color in both pigments and expression in her mark making. She began painting in earnest in 1962 after the death of her husband, and though she had a degree in home economics, she never really received a formal education in art. Rather, she cultivated a love of art by visiting museums and galleries extensively through her life and joining sketching groups and developing a community of artists with similar interests. So hanging around art, being around artists, listening and learning and experimenting. When we take in her work, we can make note of the influence of the art of artists like Jack Bush and Helen Frankenthaler, both prominent abstract artists, in the application of her paint. In this case, the paint is very thinly applied in washes or flowing stains of color. The 1970s, which this painting predates by 2 years, was a particularly productive time for her, seeing her spend time in Cape Dorset, taking inspirations from the landscapes, especially Arctic ones, and working closely with Inuit artists experimenting with acrylic painting. In reference to another later series of works for her, Graham comments, "I strive to bring to these paintings in an abstract way the dynamic life force which I find in nature." In Alleluia, painted only 6 years into her practice, we can find this is already a compelling motivation in her works and offers a lot to explore in terms of organic expressions of a spiritual connection to nature. And I think the term Alleluia in particular, probably for most of us, has that sort of spiritual connotation. Since this painting has such an interesting radial form, perhaps we can take a moment and see if we can bring a tactile element to our experience. And I'm gonna maybe ask you first, just to get to know your materials. So most abstract artists, the appeal of it is to play with your materials and really explore what they can do for you and how they respond to each other. You can't really do that unless you really get into the feel and understand your materials. So we're just gonna start with the paper that's going to act as our canvas in the same way that Graham uses her canvas. So we have this white background. If you don't have white paper, that's okay. But let's really sort of take our hands and take a moment just to feel that paper. Okay, so our paper maybe could also even be in the portrait orientation that Graham's painting is also in. And maybe if you're sighted, consider doing this entire activity without looking. Try not to peek at what you're doing. Just activate yourself through the sensation in your hands. So start by exploring the paper. Does your paper have any tooth? So this is the feeling of the fibers on the paper. I'm using a watercolor paper, so it actually has quite a bit of tooth, so I can feel those edges. And it would be really interesting if we could touch, and we can't, but if we could touch K.M. Graham's piece, it would be really interesting to see what she did to prep that canvas and what we could feel through it. Also explore, if you can, the edges of your paper. Don't give yourself a paper cut, but take yourself to the edges. See if you can gain a sort of sense of muscle memory just by sort of sensing where the papers end and begins. How much space do you have just by feeling that paper? Okay. When you've given that a chance and you've really sort of made yourself known to the paper, you're gonna grab your bobby pins, whatever you like. I have multiple colors, I have multiple sizes. It's really nice if you have bobby pins that maybe have different textures. And it's just to make this a little bit more interesting. And again, I'm gonna challenge you to not use your eyes if you're sighted when you do this activity, and just see if you can trust your hands. And you're gonna put the bobby pins down on your paper, and I want you just to start spreading them out. So the first thing we want to do is we want to sort of see if we can tap into the radial motions that Graham has offered us. So see first if you can line up your bobby pins in the direction that you want to go. Again, try not to look if you're sighted. So line them up, use as many of them as you can, and we're going to fill this canvas. And in your lining up, think about how you're directing them. What is that sensation? Can you line them up so that your paper is filled right to the edges? Okay. Think about the sound that they're making too. So I didn't intend for this to have a strong sound element, but when you're making something, you can't help but make at least a little bit of noise. So move those around with your hand, and then remember that I started the description of this with the center of the painting, which contains the silhouette of a heart that only has the background, the white backdrop behind it. So see, as you're moving, as you're organizing, just with your hands, can you trust your hands? And see if you can make that heart shape. So as you're doing this, pay attention to your movements. Pay attention to how you sense direction with just your hands, with just feeling, how you line things up. How do you remember where you put things if you're not looking? Think about the effort that goes into that. How does it make you feel? What is it like to just touch what you're doing? Spend some time with that. This video is short, but certainly you can spend as much time as you like. See if you can find that meditative quality. Maybe you will have that alleluia moment as you work, and you can do this over and over again. But at the end of it, hopefully, you end up with something that looks like this. So I'm holding up a smaller piece of paper than I had before, and I've taped all my bobby pins that are different colors and sizes as I created a textile work, keep mixing those two words up, that mimics camgrams. And I've taped them down, and you can do that too. I've just used basic Scotch tape, but if you even want to glue them down, you now have this raised relief version of this piece, and you can think about how it might connect you to this artist, and having a piece of work in your home that that you not only made, but that you could touch. So I hope that was fun for you. I hope by being able to both create a version of KM Graham's Alleluia and have a tactile experience with it, that it really sort of gave you an entry point for this work, especially if you're somebody who maybe doesn't love abstract work. I love this work, so I hope you do too. And I just want to thank everybody for taking the time to explore this work with me in this video. So I just want to say bye and hope that you have some more fun engaging in multisensory experiences at the AGO. Good night.